2003 Mercedes-Benz Cup here from the campus of UCLA in Westwood, California, as the number 5 seed Mark Philippoussis takes on the number 7 seed Wayne Ferreira. Beautiful night for tennis, 76 degrees, very little wind, and absolutely clear skies, and it doesn't get much better than this.
Yeah, perfect conditions and a late arriving crowd, as is the custom in LA. But Mark Philippoussis, 26 years old, really in the prime of his career, and perhaps trying to make up for some of the years he missed over the last couple with the knee problems, and really showing that all the hard work he is putting in is beginning to pay off. Finals at Wimbledon and moving into the top 20 in the ATP rankings, and certainly again on the move up.
I think a lot of people thought he had a shot at the Wimbledon crown this year, but Roger Federer a little too tough. Well, his opponent tonight, the veteran from South Africa, now living in the Bay Area up in Berkeley, California.
Yeah, truly the veteran out of Joburg. But again, having a fine season and really just sidelined by the groin injury at Wimbledon. And this is really his first event since that time. And he has looked good here this week, playing his usual brand of stylish, athletic tennis. He really knows how to play and win from anywhere on the court.
And last night, Leaf, again, in that match against Sebastian Grosjean, a semifinalist at Wimbledon, certainly I think Ferreira looked about as good as we've ever seen him. I mean, he hit some baseline shots against Grosjean that were sensational. Look at their head-to-head.
Yeah, and you have to play well to take out a guy like Grosjean, and you have to play well to beat Philippoussis, and Ferreira has done just that. I mean, he really has gotten his number in the past.
Will that have a bearing on Philippoussis as he starts this match tonight, knowing that he hasn't done well against Ferreira?
I think it will. I mean, that kind of stuff gets in your head a little bit, and at the same time, though, I think he's saying, hey, I'm 26. Ferreira's 31. I've got to start taking care of these veterans and knocking them off more consistently.
We will watch it closely as Ferreira goes way back behind that baseline. Last night, Kjartan gave Philippoussis about 8 or 9 paces, and Ferreira looks like he's going to do the exact same thing. We're ready to go now. First game, first set, best of 3 for a chance to move into the finals. Just a bit of a delay. Here we go. We'll go long. That's nice. Love 15.
And that's what Ferreira does well. He gets balls back into play. Yet when he has time, he's going around and just wallop the forehand. Full swinger on that forehand side. Very dangerous shot.
That's wide. Get a chance to look at that big serve of Philippoussis's tonight. It is just about a perfect motion. Rolls that body into it so well. Philippoussis forehand.
And here is where Wayne Ferreira is so strong. He's got the experience, athleticism, finds ways to win. At times temperamental, however, and if his shots don't go long, there may be a tendency for Philippoussis to step up and tee off from the middle of the court. So he's got to maintain length against the big guy.
Love 30. Well, we just saw a winning combination for Ferreira right there. That forehand 1-2 punch. Beautiful shot from the South African. And Philippoussis is going for a little too much. And now a big opportunity for Wayne Ferreira. Triple break point. Goes wide, and so Wayne Ferreira in the very first game of this match breaks serve at love.
And a good start for the South African. And you have to say, who has the edge in this match? Well, it's pretty even. I think I might give Philippoussis a slight edge on the forehand. Although Ferrer does have a big one, and Ferrer with the two-hander, perhaps a little more versatile. Philippoussis the serve and the volleys. And again, on the defensive side, Ferrer with the return and the better movement around the court. So if Ferrer can get the big Australian off balance, he will have a real edge today. Who do you think is going to go to, Bear?
I'll deal with that in just a moment here, as Ferrer has yet to lose a point. Wide. My question is, whoever that edge expert might be, I'd have to disagree on the forehand from Ferrer. I think Ferrer's forehand is a tougher shot because he disguises it so well. Is it true that the edge expert is you?
It was me. But in order for me to make it even, I had to give him the forehand, and I did.
You've retired already from that job? All right, 15-all.
See, Ferrer's going with the Bjorn Borg sort of growth. He hasn't shaved in a few days. Perhaps he's got a little winning formula there.
Well, that'll go perfect in Berkeley. Well, we should tell everybody Wayne Ferrer has been helping Peter Wright, who is the tennis coach up at the University of California in Berkeley, Northern California. He's been, when he's home, he helps him out with the team, which is really a great thing for kids on that Berkeley team. Ferrer at 40-15, trying to hold in the second game of the first set. Ooh, that ball will go wide. Ferrer dishes up his first double of the night. Still up, 40-30.
So when Ferrer first came on the tour back in 89, everyone thought he looked like Doogie Howser, M.D. Remember the actor in that young show? And of course, now he's 31-year-old elder statesman of the game, $10 million in prize money later.
Just going to say, how many people have you asked him on the sidewalks in New York, how much money has Wayne Ferrer won? Almost $10 million in prize money. Not bad. Well, his second double puts him in trouble. Now Philippoussis with a chance to break right back here in game number two. Let first serve. Another lead. Carlos Bernardes in the chair, and we have an electronic net caller strapped to the top of that net. Oh, and a miss hit off the forehand. And so Philippoussis gets right back into this first set. Two breaks of serve in the first two games.
Well, that time, Ferrer's strength let him down. He mishit the forehand over the baseline, and just a bit of a loose game there. He was up 40-15.
Yeah. Two doubles.
Yeah, wanting to try and consolidate that break. That you don't break Mark Philippoussis' serve that often, and he was off to a great start. And here he hands the break right back.
He's thinking about it, too. You can see he is very disappointed, because when you have Philippoussis down a break, you really need to consolidate. Third game. That's too good.
There's that forehand. There's that forehand that Shira said was so strong.
That wasn't bad, I'll tell you.
But this is the short ball I was talking about. If you cough up the short one, he's going to make that forehand. You know, as will Ferrer. I mean, most of the great players in the game these days are going to hurt you from the center of the court.
It's a let. Well, I think the ground strokes of Philippoussis for sure in the last 18 months have improved immeasurably. He's much more patient than he used to be. Let and a fault. just wide. Guerra trying to do a little too much with that shot. Pulls it wide.
Yeah, nice work from Philippoussis, though, moving around the court. And I think that is evidence of Philippoussis' commitment to his fitness. I mean, he got that forehand, stretched all the way out on the backhand, moving well early. Philippoussis, who lives just down the road in San Diego now. Says he's waking up every morning, going surfing for a couple hours every day.
Oh, he overhits it.
And he broke up with his longtime coach, Peter McNamara, a fellow Australian who had worked with Philippoussis since he was a very young player, 13, 14 years old. Spending more time now with his dad, Nick, traveling with him.
Oh.
There's his father, watching nervously. Boy, had to be so proud of his son reaching that Wimbledon final. That's the kind of tennis I think a lot of people expected from Mark Philippoussis, particularly on grass. Nearly got it done, but he ran into the better man on the day.
Oh, way wide. I remember that 99 quarterfinal at Wimbledon against Pete Sampras when it looked like Philippoussis had Sampras definitely beat, and then that's when he pulled the knee and had to have arthroscopic surgery. And to me, that was a big part of his career, big point in his career. He's come back strong. Philippoussis gets out of trouble once again with the big serve.
And I think at that point in the match, when he injured his knee against Sampras, he was up a set and a break.
Yeah.
And he was playing some of the finest tennis of his young career at that point. And since then, it's been real struggles with the knee. And I think right now, finally, he's back to full health. I think that's beginning to show in the results.
Call service ace number one for Philippoussis. 117 miles per hour, took a little off that ball.
Took a little off it, yeah, at 117.
People would be happy to have a flat first serve with that speed. Game point. Number two, right down the center. And so Mark Philippoussis holds. Stay with us. We're at the 2003 Mercedes-Benz Cup. Two games to one. Mark Philippoussis leading here. A couple of service breaks, and then finally a hold by Philippoussis, as Wayne Ferreira prepares to serve in the fourth game of the first set. Remember when Ferreira kind of broke on the scene at the Memphis tournament years ago, Leaf, and everybody just marveled at how hard he hit the ball and yet kept it in play. And what a career he has had. Very strong, long-lasting career if you think about all the matches he's played around the world over the last 10 years.
It's funny to see Wayne Ferreira with that bit of beard. You know, normally he's clean shaven, but I remember Bjorn Borg, he never would shave as long as he was winning. So by the time he got to the second weekend at Wimbledon, he was always a bit scruffy looking. I always liked the philosophy, Barry. I tried to do it myself. Two problems. First, I didn't have enough facial hair. And second, I was never winning enough to get scruffy.
for the Green Hall.
Yeah, that's a nice combination. First serve, not really a serve and volley, but he saw the floating return, moved in and took it on the fly. See how he's just waiting, but then he pops forward. That's not an easy shot.
No.
Handle it well.
Oh, he's a great athlete. Wonderful hands, good timing. I think this guy could play almost any sport. Just leans into that backhand open court. Beautiful shot.
Yeah, this is not an easy shot right here, because remember, Ferrer gets his ball up pretty high and he just leans on it. He gets on top of it. And remember, he's also changing the line of attack here. He's taking a ball coming cross court and just straightening it out. That takes a clean backhand.
And Ferreira with the winner. Right up the line he holds. We're at two games all.
And you talk about Ferrer being a great sport. He is a natural sportsman. He plays golf very easily and very well. When he was young, he played a number of different sports and gravitated to tennis and really has excelled at it from the juniors on. He's always been a great player.
South Africa's produced quite a few good players, maybe more recently, not so recently, Cliff Drysdale, Gordon Forbes, Abe Siegel, Eric Sturgis, a host of great players from South Africa. Wow. That's superb tennis. A great get from Philip Poussis. And then Ferreira just leans on that two-hander.
Yeah, if you're going to make an argument that tennis players may be the best athletes in the world, you know, you can watch this point and say, well, you know, that might be right. Because look at these guys covering the court. And look at this shot. Sets up the court, just opens up the court a little bit more.
Net cord, and it goes wide. Ferreira gets a break, because if that ball gets over, there is no play on it. And now, once again, Ferreira with a chance here. Love 30. Fifth game, first set. It's a fault.
Management there from Philip Poussis. You know, he hit a couple backhands, got into a rhythm, but then stepped around and got the forehand into play. And he can really torque the forehand with plenty of spin. Oh, what a weapon. When you're behind in the count, and you can just throw a strike like that.
Ace number three, 128 miles per hour. So from love 30 down, Philip Poussis gets even. It's a fault. Mark, Philip Poussis looking over 134 miles per hour. Ferreira got his racket on it. Into that wheelhouse, and he fires away a clean winner cross court.
Again, just stepping into it, and you say came right over the plate. He just stroked it.
Break point.
Yeah, the second serve, that's a good time to be aggressive.
Too tough a serve, a weak return.
Yeah, Philippoussis is backing up that first serve so well. Again, getting around the backhand to bring the forehand into play.
And Ferreira almost bumps into the lines person. He is so far behind that baseline. He's about 3 feet away from that guy calling the sideline. Way back.
Well, Philippoussis' first serve is a nice serve to watch from a distance. You don't want to get hit by this serve.
Well, he also moves up as Philippoussis makes his move. Catches the net. So once again, Ferreira with a big opportunity here.
This is captivating stuff to watch these guys square off from the backcourt, because each of them is looking for that chance to get around and pop the forehand. And that time it was a South African who really straightened it out beautifully down the line.
Ferreira gives him that look way back, and then as he gets ready to return, he'll move in. There he goes. So actually, when Philippoussis looks over there, Leaf, he sees him about 4 or 5 feet further back than he actually returns the ball. It's wide, and another break opportunity disappears for Ferreira.
And I think this court is slow enough that Ferreira is going to be able to get enough serves back into play that he's going to be able to break Philippoussis' serve. Now, you can't count on that, but certainly it's looking like that. He's played a number of close games on the Philippoussis serve.
Dumps it into the net. A high bouncing serve.
Well, that time Philippoussis served and volleyed. So Ferreira was thinking, okay, I've got to keep the ball down low, and he pulled it down into the net. So some good variety from the Australian, who had not really served and volleyed.
Up, changed his mind, nets the ball, and Philippoussis gets away with murder. Stay with us. We're on the Tennis Channel. Semifinals from Los Angeles. Back to the 2003 Mercedes-Benz Cup, and it is awfully tough to return the big serve of Mark Philippoussis. Here's what Wayne Ferreira had to say about that.
You know, he's serving so huge, and he's hitting the ball so hard that it's going to be tough. You know, the main focus on that one obviously is just trying to get the serve back. You know, once you can get it back and you can put yourself in a position to get in the rally, have a good chance, but getting that serve back is really tough.
Well, we will watch closely because Ferreira is moving around a lot on that baseline, Leaf. He's 10 feet behind, then he moves up. He's trying everything to get that serve back. Ferreira serving now. Six game, first set.
And there is Ferreira well back behind the baseline. But watch how he steps up. And there he is trying to take it early.
You know, he's completely different from Gustavo Kuerten, who last night started back and stayed back and hit fantastic shots from way behind the baseline. This guy moves up a little bit. 30 love. Big serve down the center.
And this is a good service game from Ferreira, because when you play a guy like Philippoussis who has the big serve, I think there's a sense that, you know, I have got to take care of my own serve. Otherwise, I could be out the door.
It's a fault. 40 love, a chance for Ferreira to get to 3-all. That will go long. So Philippoussis has taken some chances as the errors. We are at 3 games all, first set.
Yeah, and that's the first time that Ferrer has had a love service game. So that's a comfortable way to get your work done on your own serve. And you shift that pressure back onto your opponent's shoulders.
Ferreira, a bronze medalist at the 1992 Olympic tennis competition over in Barcelona. First South African to do that in 32 years. Service ace number 4 down the center.
Just a beautiful tennis point from both players, and Ferreira ultimately getting the best of it. And did you see Philippoussis? You know, he was in the midair adjusting to playing that one backhand.
A 200-pound ballerina. 15-all.
I'd hate to see him in a 2-2, really.
No, it's wide.
Wouldn't you come in? I'd be coming behind that serve a little bit more. I mean, that's 125-mile-an-hour serve. And he's staying back. I just feel like, hey, you got to come in and volley that occasionally. He's getting into some trouble here.
Another chance here for Ferreira. 15-30, seventh game. It's wide.
I think we see that in the modern game these days, you know, this over-reliance on hitting winners from the backcourt instead of, you know, setting up a good high volley. You know, guys are really insistent on playing the ball on the bounce.
It's a fault.
Whereas you and I would don't let the ball bounce.
Bring the baseline in with you. Long, just over the baseline from Ferreira. Now Philippoussis with a chance to hold. Service ace number 5 for Mark Philippoussis. He holds serve. Stay with us. We're on the Tennis Channel bringing you semifinal action from Los Angeles, the 2003 Mercedes-Benz Cup. Welcome back to Los Angeles. A look at the former middleweight champion of the world, Sugar Ray Leonard. He's having a good time, Leaf. I remember a fortnight at Wimbledon when he followed Martina Navratilova very closely and just really actually helped her win Wimbledon that year. A great tennis enthusiast, Sugar Ray.
He should feel right at home here with these guys, with the punches these guys are throwing.
That's
you know, knockout punches from both forehand wing.
No, we got a middleweight going against a heavyweight tonight. Here's the heavyweight. There's the middleweight.
Yeah, the tail of the tape. Philippoussis has more reach. Ferreira a little quicker. He's going to have to win with his heart and his mind. Philippoussis is going to win with a hammer.
15 low. That's too good. An inside-out forehand from Ferreira. Very effective shot. What a return.
Jeez, he hammered that.
quick game for Ferreira once again on his own serve. Yeah. Gets us to 4-all.
Two consecutive love games, so Ferreira settling in nicely on his serve. There is his coach, David Nankin. He has to feel good about where his man is at, which is dead even here in the opening set. They've traded breaks to serve in the first two games of the match, but since then, it's been all on serve.
Let first serve. No. Big serve out wide from Filipoussis.
And here's the scouting report on the big guy. Big game, full of confidence, with a major weapon in the serve. And if you can get him off balance, perhaps you can start chipping away at his mental strength. But you know, after you get to a Wimbledon final, you have to be feeling pretty good about your game.
Yeah. Yeah, I think his confidence level is very strong right now. We'll go long. All of a sudden, no points at all, no rallies, just serve and an error. Six quick points from both players. Slice stays so low from the backhand of Ferreira.
That's what I like about Filipoussis' game, too. If you watch him play, for a big guy, he's very sort of fluid, and he can play all the shots. He can create the backspin, the underspin, the topspin. He really plays with wonderful variety. Almost an all-court player, not just a power merchant.
Hate to call him the poor man's Roger Federer. But after watching Federer at Wimbledon, boy, he was brilliant. Shot does not work. A risky shot from Filipoussis, and Ferreira was right there. He would have handled that ball. Now big points here. Four games all, 30 all.
Now, this is the kind of situation where you like to step up to the line knowing you've got the first serve in your pocket. I'm sure he's going to give this one a ride, perhaps down the tee. He likes that low part of the net.
He does. Right there, and Ferreira missing with the return, and so Filipoussis now at game point. Left first serve.
I'm surprised that serve doesn't just snap the net. 130 miles an hour right into the tape.
Another let. Filipoussis saying the ball was over by 6 inches. How could it be a let? Carlos Bernardes, the umpire in the chair.
I think if Carlos said, you know, I didn't see it, I think most everyone would say, yeah, you're about right. I wouldn't have seen it either.
He might have heard it.
Whistling by the net.
From Filipoussis, and Ferreira trying to get the break here.
It just overcooked that forehand a little bit. It didn't need all that gas on it.
It's the first bit of impatience we've seen from Filipoussis all evening.
We can see he really resets himself well. You can see he's trying to get his breathing under control, trying to slow himself down to focus on this particular serve.
Terrific passing shot with a two-hander. Great anticipation by Ferreira.
Yeah, and again, I just think the point lost something when he didn't play the serve and volley there. You know, by letting the ball bounce, Ferreira could at least set his feet underneath him.
And now the biggest point of this match thus far, break point at 4-all. And when he needs it, the scud, 128 miles per hour, it's deuce. Ferreira with a solid return off that two-hander.
Now, a little bit of luck, too, is that one? He kind of steered it off the edge, and it hit the edge of the line.
Once again, break point. Oh, right down the center, 130 miles per hour, his sixth ace of the evening.
And you can see how he's taking his time here, because normally players, when they start feeling the pressure of a match, they start doing things more quickly, and they get out of their rhythm. And I think you're seeing a more mature Philippoussis here as he takes his time, steps up, tries to establish that good preparation.
Slices it wide, and for the third time now, Ferreira with a chance to break. And there it is, as Philippoussis rolls over that forehand, and Wayne Ferreira has broken serve to go up 5-4 in the first set. We're on the Tennis Channel, semifinal action from the 2003 Mercedes-Benz Cup. When we return, this man serves for the first set. Five games to four now. Wayne Ferreira steps up to the baseline to try and close out this first set. Maybe the toughest game of any set when you're up 5-4 and trying to close it. Nice change of pace out wide.
Yeah, the last game can be the toughest to win in any set or match. But boy, you get a first serve in like that, that'll help you get through it.
As our old friend Billie Jean King used to say, got to finish. Oh, a big miss hit way over the baseline. Now Ferreira, two quick points. 30 love and 2 points away. Left first serve. Side out forehand. Brilliant shot from Ferreira. Takes him to triple set point. It's a fault. And a slice right down the line. A clean winner from Wayne Ferreira. He has won the first set. Stay with us. We're on the Tennis Channel semifinals. The South African with the first set, 6-4. For all you Star Trek junkies out there, William Shatner enjoying the tennis. He's a great tennis fan and loves to hit a few balls around. He's been here on more than one occasion this week. But right now, Mark Philippoussis with his hands full. That's a good look at the luxury boxes high above this beautiful center court here at the LA Tennis Center. This venue, the home of the 1984 Olympic tennis competition, when it was a demonstration sport. It was won by Stefan Edberg on the men's side and Steffi Graf on the ladies. A couple pretty good young players in those days. go long.
Now, perhaps Philippoussis, sensing that he's got to do something different, served and volleyed. So, tactical adjustment by the Australian.
It's wide. Philippoussis thought he had the ace. He has another look at the points to a mark, which would have to be on the line.
Now, Carlos Bernardi's wisely. He's not going to overrule a call on the far sideline. I mean, that's an area you have to leave it up to the linesman.
Oh, yeah. And a second serve ace from Philippoussis, his seventh of the night.
And I'm sure he's thinking, I told you it was good. I told you it was good.
Oh, no. Philippoussis cranking it up down the center quickly to 40 love.
You know, oftentimes when you lose that first set, Barry, those close calls look good to you.
Exactly.
When you're playing from behind all of a sudden.
Second serve. Oh, and Ferreira, who has a wide open court, tries to roll it cross court. Does not work. And so Philippoussis holds. One love, second set.
But I think that was an important game for Philippoussis. If he looks at what he did there, you know, he served and volleyed. He took the attack off the serve into the net instead of spending so much time in the backcourt. I mean, this guy Ferreira is nails from the back.
Oh, yeah, you don't want to get into rallies with him. Catches the tape. Wide open court.
Well, you know, our old friend Alan Fox was not only a fine player, but a great tactician, a great coach. He always said, you know, who's hurting who with what? And in this case, it's Ferreira hurting Philippoussis from the back.
It's wide.
And I think Philippoussis has to change that tactic and say, hey, I'm going to try and hurt you by imposing pressure, you know, when I'm ahead in the rally.
Alan Fox, doctor of psychology, former coach up at Pepperdine. Haven't seen him this week. Oh, yes. Ferreira, the inside-out forehand once again.
Well, Alan Fox, the writer of two great tennis books that I consider almost my tennis Bibles. I mean, he really was a very knowledgeable guy who took the game really to another level in terms of interpretation.
Just wide. It did not miss by much. Well, Philippoussis now with a chance here. Second game, 30 all. And a rolled forehand up the line catches Ferreira. And now a big chance for Philippoussis.
And Ferreira just doesn't do enough with this volley. Just plays it a little casual.
Yeah. Just wide. Unsighted from that side linesman, and Carlos Bernardes made the call. Let's listen.
It's like this much off. You can see that this much off. He was unsighted. It was this much off.
The side linesman held the hands up to his eyes because Ferreira ran right in front of him. And Carlos Bernardes took charge in a hurry. I think he handled that very well.
Yeah, I think he has to be careful, though, to say, you know, the mark shows us clearly out, because you don't want to go by the mark. Because the player will say, well, look at this mark's good. Are you going to go by that mark?
Exactly. No, it's wide. Philippoussis now starting to come in more, Leaf. I think he heard you. Another chance. Break point. some heavyweight hitting from both players. Great depth.
But you'd hope to play a shot with some purpose there. And I just felt like Philippoussis was hitting out without any real purpose. You know, I think what he wants to think about is, hey, get to net. You know, yeah, create a situation where I can get in as opposed to just hitting a clean winner. Is that a strategy? I don't know. I mean, if you're hitting winners, it's a great strategy. If you're not, boy, it's going to be a long day.
Oh, another error from Ferreira. And once again, Philippoussis with a chance to go up 2-love. Called out, Ruben Wallace. This is going to be trouble, I think, from Philippoussis. Let's listen. The lines person did not make the call.
I thought about that. He didn't call. I need to call. He didn't call. I need to call. I thought about something. Yeah, I know, but he didn't call. I need to make a call. Yeah.
Can't believe Ferreira's unhappy with that.
I know, that was on me. That was on me. Okay, in your opinion, yeah, but I need to step in if he didn't call, okay?
Where's the base linesman? Who did not make the call. Carlos Bernardes picked it up from the chair. And that's what irritated Philippoussis. It's deuce. It's going to go long.
And yeah, that's kind of a bad break for Philippoussis. And I'm just not sure that there was a clear gap there between the ball and the baseline. I felt like Carlos Bernardes perhaps jumped in where he didn't need to.
He's made 2 calls from the chair this game, and both against Philippoussis. That is wide, and so Ferreira gets out of trouble thanks to a couple of close calls. It's 1-1, second set. Now look at the ball now. This is the controversial call on the baseline.
Thought it was out, Barry?
Clearly long.
Oh, come on. That ball hits the line. Look at that. Come on. That's on the line.
Ooh. The line expands, they tell me electronically, on those replays. That's a high-tech deal.
But, I mean, was that a clear error? I mean, obviously, it's very close to call, but how close is a clear error? That's the, you know, that's the rule. Is there a clear error? I don't know.
15, love. Let first serve.
You know, some people have advocated putting, you know, machines on all the lines, but I certainly don't want that. I love the human element on the tennis court, and that's what makes tennis such a fascinating sport as well, is that you have the breaks go your way some days, and others they don't.
A fault. Yeah, I kind of miss the net court judges with that electronic deal out there. I used to love to watch those guys. They started wearing hard hats because they got hit so often. They're gone. There is a solid return from Ferreira. 15 all.
Well, the weight of shot around the men's tour these days. Yeah. I think there were some lives being threatened if there were any more guys with their fingers on the net.
Has taken that extra step, got himself very close to the net on that volley.
And again, he moves quickly to the ball. Yeah. Nice execution.
That's exactly what you're talking about, Leaf. Yeah, that extra step gave him the punch. 30-15. Sideline just wide. Lapus is looking up at Bernardo saying, you want to overrule that one?
I think Bernardi's going to lay off that one, huh?
I think so.
Maybe just keep score for a while.
Game point. Big serve down the center. That's good. And Rivera gets caught, tries one behind his back, and Lapus is. Settles down, holds serve, and now 2-1. Lapus is up. Second set. Carlos in the chair there, really under some pressure.
I think that would be a hot seat right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, he is on the hot seat. He overruled two balls against Lapus. But Lapus has settled down, held serve, and now 2-1. Lapus is in the second set. Touch. Here's what we talked about, the all-court game from Ferreira.
Yeah, he can pack power on this forehand, but also a little bit of finesse. You can see him just rolling it cross-court.
Great touch. And back with an ace.
If I were Bernardi's, I'd be a little wary of overruling calls by a guy who I look eye to eye on when I'm sitting in the chair. I mean, Lapus is a big guy. I get him mad.
Net court. Look at this point. That's spectacular. Just spectacular from Wayne Ferreira.
And spectacular from the Australian as well. I mean, that was just a brilliant point.
Ferreira, first he rolls a little touch forehand, then he serves an ace, then he hits an outright winner on the forehand. This guy is really impressive.
Yeah, okay, maybe you're right. Maybe Ferreira has a little bit better forehand. We'll give the edge to his forehand next time.
That edge guy again. And there it is, a quick game for Ferreira. He holds to even this second set at 2-all.
Well, his last service game, he's looked down the barrel of 3 break points. It's nice to get an easy one in now.
Ferreira looks very much in this match to me, concentrating well.
Yeah, and that's always been his Achilles heel, Barry, hasn't it? He's just been a little temperamental, sometimes vulnerable to sort of going walkabout.
Yeah.
Hey, this is some very high quality tennis. That was a heck of a half volley off a very tricky return.
Gives it one of those Sampras leaping overheads. If the Lakers are watching this guy, they're probably thinking, man, we'd like to draft this fellow. Let him dunk a few down at Staples Pavilion. Oh, yes. Ferreira. Big forehand down the line.
I think Lapus did everything right here, but he just loaded up this ball right on Ferreira's racket. You know, just flicked it.
Oh, there is classic serve and volley from Lapus.
He can do it all, can he? And that time he got his shoulders around on the volley. to give it a little bit of gas inside out. Not an easy volley by any means. You really have to move well.
Second serve. Rapusis looked like he didn't hear it. He'll call service ace on a second serve. His eighth of the game. Mark Philippoussis, the Australian scud. Up, up, and away. Center court, the Los Angeles Tennis Center here in Westwood, California, on the campus of UCLA. A great turnout tonight for semifinal action as Wayne Ferreira has won the first set, opens with an ace. His third of the match, 15 love. Just gets caught, tries to sort of cup that slice forehand return, a little long.
Right idea.
Yeah.
But just poor execution, you know, just needs to clean it up a little bit more and he'll be fine.
Another one of these games where Ferreira just breezes along to 40 love quickly. See if he can hold at love. Missed by much. And it's long, and he does. And Wayne Ferreira just breezing along with four quick points. Gets the score to 3-all.
Yeah, and those are nice ways to win your serve when you can plow through very quickly. Philippoussis feels like, you know, I just finished my serve a moment ago. Do I have to serve again?
You know, Ferreira is amazing. Watching him leave, he is so effortless. He just sort of glides around out there. Great coordination. And he's playing about as well as we've seen him tonight. Three games all. Ferreira with the first set. Leighton Hewitt already out into the finals. The winner of this match will take on Hewitt for the championship tomorrow. Oh. Let in a fault. Philippoussis serves and volleys. It's working for him. He just hasn't done it enough.
I'll tell you, when he gets to the net, he is a very difficult man to get the ball by. I mean, he's got a tremendous wingspan. He's very tall, difficult to lob over.
No, it's caught. Actually kind of overplayed that ball. 15 all, big points now. Seventh game, second set. Ferreira with the first. This is best of three. Again, beautiful volley from that backhand side.
Yeah, this is just classic. You know, wide to wide tennis. You serve out wide and you volley out wide.
No. Solid low return from Ferreira catches Philippoussis. And now 30 all. Now, what do you think is going through Philippoussis' mind? Shall I keep coming in?
Yeah, I think he's just going to keep attacking big down the tee. Use your strength, which is your big serve, to try and close it out. Well, he crossed me up there, went out wide. He also crossed up Ferreira.
Ace number 9 for the Australian scud. He had 22 big aces last night in that to titanic win over Gustavo Kuerten. Two-hander, way up around his shoulder, and makes the angle shot.
Yeah, and that's a big advantage when you have the two hands, because your left hand helps you pull that ball cross-court. Ferrer really showcasing that return here tonight. He's used it very effectively.
No call. Service ace number 10 for Philippoussis. 129 miles per hour. Tries a tricky little drop volley, does not work. Ooh, that was risky.
Yeah, he's really making this job more difficult than it should be. I mean, this is a floating ball. You know, do something solid. And this is a tough play against a quick man like Ferrer. Davis Cup side this Australian team has. Mark Philippoussis and Leighton Hewitt.
Yeah.
They are in the semifinals. They'll take on Switzerland.
And there it is. Philippoussis holds. 4-3 now. Philippoussis up. Stay with us. 4-3 Philippoussis. Second set. Welcome back to Center Court. You're looking at Steve Bellamy, the president and founder of the Tennis Channel, enjoying the tennis out here tonight. And the Tennis Channel has been very much in evidence all week long here at this tournament, picking up the coverage on Tuesday and coordinating off the television. Eric continues with that forehand. 15 love.
That's a shot that Philippoussis has trouble with. You know, it's a very low ball down at his ankles, yeah. But he really comes up too quickly on it. Your old friend Pancho Segura used to say, you've got to stay down with the ball.
Mighty Segu. Oh, Ferrer, a rare error off that forehand side. Trying to do a little too much with it. 30-15. Baseline. Suddenly the forehand of Philippoussis letting him down. 40-15. Look at those unforced errors. A lot of them on the forehand side of Philippoussis. And Ferrer slices one out wide. He holds easily again. 4-all.
Ferrer has gotten a lot of his good work tonight done on the forehand side. Again, great preparation. Look at the shoulder turn. He loads that energy in his legs, and then you can see he really uncoils into the shot. And again, he brushes up from below the ball right before impact just to add a little bit of control. So even though he's taking a big swing, Barry, he's adding control by adding spin.
I think it's one of the best forehands in the men's game, without question. 15 love. And 30 love, ace number 11. It's a let. Yes. I don't think he wanted to make it quite that good. Ball right on the sideline.
Right. And you can see why he was in the finals of Wimbledon. I mean, that's a nice serve and volley combination.
Ace number 12 in Philippoussis serves one of the best games in the match for him. He goes up 5-4. When we return, Wayne Ferreira will serve to stay in the second set. Welcome back to the 2003 Mercedes-Benz Cup. Is that Chris Evert in this? No, it's not. Sure looked like her for a minute. 5-4, Philippoussis, second set.
Well, this is the one advantage you have if you serve first, because now Ferreira has to serve to stay in the set. If Philippoussis can engineer a break, this match is dead even.
Love 15, he's got a shot. That's a fault. And a great approach shot. Philippoussis was in perfect position there and gets passed.
Yeah, that was just a dynamite pass because he was tested. That ball had some underspin. Ferreira just turned it over cross court.
Now Philippoussis coming to life here when he needs it. 15-30. He is 2 points away from evening this match at a set apiece. Ferreira right back with ace number 5. Shot goes wide.
Yes, that's one of those moments where you just want to hit the ball deep and in the corner and make your opponent come up with something good, and Philippoussis just steered it into the alley.
He knows it. He had a big opportunity there.
It's a painful miss.
Second serve. We'll see if Philippoussis continues to come in behind this shot. No. And he slices it long, and Ferreira gets out of trouble. And so now, 5 games all, second set.
And Philippoussis has been a little bit patchy in his play tonight. Do you think there's any residual hangover from that win over Kirtan? You know, any sort of fatigue?
Could be very much so, Leap, because there's Nick, Mark's father, Nick Philippoussis. Yeah, that was a very tough match for both players last night. And I think he still might be recovering just slightly from that match. Look at this. Look at this shot by Ferreira. Tremendous get by Wayne Ferreira, and he controls it.
Now that is a brilliant pass. Somehow he's able to manufacture a two-handed backhand out of this long run. Look at him just turn that over. Oh. I tell you, Philippoussis almost hits it with the wrong side of the racket for a winner.
What a get by Ferreira. Love 15, second serve, 5 games all. Oh, and another solid return from the South African, and now trouble for Philippoussis. Love 30, big points here. From Philippoussis on a difficult return. That was not an easy ball, Leaf.
He had to hit it well because Ferreira was on the move, tracking it down.
This is really solid tennis now. Good quality play from both players. That's a fault. Second serve. And it stays in. A fantastic lob from Ferreira just inside the baseline.
Yeah, you're right, Barry. This is fantastic. Look at how he creates that and just punches a little lob up, underspun, one hand.
And over a 6'4" giant. And now the biggest point of the match right here, double break point. It's good. And Ferreira on the full run hits a one-handed backhand up the line. That is the best shot he has hit all week long. Stay with us. We're on the Tennis Channel when we return. Wayne Ferreira serves for the match. Six games to five now. Wayne Ferreira serving for a berth in the championship tomorrow. It's caught. Tries the little half volley. It will not work, and Filipoos is struggling to stay in it now. This was the break point as Ferreira on the full run drills that backhand right into the corner. What a shot. That is the best backhand he's hit maybe in his life. 15-all, because he's a two-handed guy, and he just went with the one-hander right into the corner. 3 points away now, 15-all. Colleague Leif Shiras is headed courtside just in case this match ends. Try and chat with the winner. It is not over yet as Filipoos stays in there. 15-30. Ferreira slowing things down a little. Time for ace number six. Takes him to 30-all, 2 points away. Out wide. That will go long. And now Wayne Ferreira, the South African, stands at match point. Over at his coach, a tremendous effort leap in two sets. He played some brilliant tennis. And so Wayne Ferreira with one of the best shots all night up that line to break serve, and a standing ovation for the South African veteran. Stay with us. We're on the Tennis Channel. Ferreira has moved into the championship round. A winner in straight sets, 6-4 and 7-5. A tremendous effort from the South African. He played some brilliant tennis tonight. He's with our Leif Shiras. Leif.
Thank you, Barry. Wayne, that best tennis we've seen you play. You really delivered against a very dangerous guy.
Yeah, I played really well. You know, against Mark, you have to be very, very tight on the serve, you know, make him play a lot. I returned extremely well, got on top. And then on my serve games, put a lot of first serves in. I just played a pretty solid match all around. I'm very happy.
I'll tell you, the last time you played, you know, in May in the French, you were carried off on a stretcher. You have to feel good that you're back healthy, playing well.
Well, I'm not fully healthy. I'm still struggling a bit with my groin. It's kind of at that stage where it's not getting worse, better or worse. So I'm playing through it. It's a little bit of pain, but, you know, it never killed anybody.
Tell me, was that the best backhand you've ever hit? Certainly one-handed backhand you've ever hit.
It's probably one of the only ones I've ever hit. It was a lucky one.
Hey, you got to take it when things are going well. They seem to be going well for you. Leighton Hewitt in the finals. What are your thoughts on playing him?
Well, I'm very happy to be in the final, firstly, but play someone like him in the final is always great. You know, he's such a great tennis player. He's been number one in the world for 2 years. It's good for me, you know, play people like that and see how good I am and how well I can play. And, you know, if I can beat him, then I'm playing about as good as anybody.
Well, now, you haven't shaved in a couple days. Now, is this a new look or is this a good luck charm?
A couple days. It's been about a month. I finally hit puberty. I thought I could grow it out now.
All right, well, the 31-year-old, you're hitting the ball pretty well. Congratulations.
Thanks, Steve.
Good luck in the final. Barry?
All right.